Hey everyone, welcome to my channel, Tiny and Tidy. I'm Vishali and I am determined to motivate you to get your messy, disorganized space nice and tidy. One question I always get from friends and my followers is how do I have time to do all of the things that I do with three kids? I think what they mean by that is how do I have time to post on social media daily, create weekly YouTube videos, cook, clean, organize, and take care of my children? Well, I have to admit that I am very lucky and have a lot of help. One child is in school, another in daycare, and I have a part-time cleaning lady that comes for 6 hours per week. Nevertheless, I still try to accomplish a lot every single day, and I make the most of the time that I do have. I've always been pretty good at time management, and since 95% of my Instagram followers wanted productivity tips, I figured I'd share my top 5 on how to be more productive. Before I get into tip number 1, I also want to make it clear that this is my 3rd maternity leave. When I had my first baby, I wasn't doing any of this stuff. That was one of the biggest challenges I ever faced in my life. There was so much I had to learn and figure out. The last thing I was doing was decluttering, organizing, cleaning, and meal planning. So if you're on baby number 1, I want you to know that it will get easier. Don't expect to do any of the stuff I talk about right now. But subscribe to my channel, and one day, when you're sleeping again, when you start to have a bit more time, then revisit my channel. Alright, now that I'm done with my PSA, let's get into tip number 1, which is making a list. I create a list for anything and everything. I truly believe that I have permanent pregnancy brain. Even though I'm not pregnant, I can't remember anything. So I make sure I'm always making lists for everything, from groceries, projects I want to complete, daily tasks, cleaning lists, books I want to read, things I have to buy, you get the point. I just make sure it's all noted down so that I don't forget anything. Now this brings me to tip number 2, planning and scheduling. Now, it's one thing to create a list of a bunch of stuff that you want to get done, and it's another thing to actually accomplish all of these things. To make sure that I'm accomplishing what's most important, I make sure I spend time every week planning and actually scheduling what I want to get done. So being a teacher for so many years has definitely made me a pro at this, since we're required to constantly plan ahead. We even get scheduled time almost every single day, called planning time, dedicated to this process. So basically, I'll go through my list and figure out what can be delegated and what actually needs to be done by me. Most of the tasks usually need to be done by me, but I have been making more of an effort to delegate whatever I can to my husband. I actually schedule the tasks and try my best to complete the tasks I have scheduled each day. If for some reason I don't get something done, I end up having to do extra work the next day and will try my best to catch up. If I manage to get all of my tasks done on a particular day, then I try to get ahead and complete future tasks. The key to success here is not over-scheduling. I try to only give myself one time-consuming task per day, and the other 2 or 3 things that I want to get done won't be as demanding. For example, in order to create this video, I scheduled one day to write the script, another day for filming it, a 3rd day to edit it, I'll upload it overnight, and then schedule a 4th day to do things like the description and thumbnail. I don't schedule writing, filming, editing, and uploading all on the same day, because that will only end up in being a major fail. However, I will schedule smaller tasks on the same day, such as cooking one meal and cleaning one small thing. You should also group tasks that are similar. For example, if I have to make a bunch of phone calls, I'll schedule them all on the same day. If I have to go out to run different errands, then they're also all scheduled on the same day. Lastly, I don't plan day by day. I plan out my entire week. It's very helpful to look at your full week, figure out what days are busier than others, so that you can plan easier tasks for those days, easier meals for those days, etc. Then on the days that aren't as hectic, you can take on a more time-consuming task. Tip number 3 is stop watching TV and monitor the time that you spend on social media. We haven't had cable for years. We tried to buy one of those satellite boxes a couple years ago, but we got scammed and the thing never worked properly, which actually ended up being a blessing in disguise. I can't imagine how much time I would have wasted if the thing actually worked. We do have Netflix, but rarely watch it. We kept it for the kids because occasionally we'll put on a movie or show for them. Anyway, TV is the biggest time waster. You don't need to keep up with the Kardashians, nor do you need to watch CNN 24/7. If something something major happens, trust me, you're gonna hear about it. I have wasted so many hours watching Netflix and the Kardashians, and I wish I could get that time back. There's so much more we could be doing to make our lives better. It's also important to monitor how much time you're spending on social media. It's very easy to spend hours a day scrolling through that Instagram feed. So make sure you're checking your activity, and if necessary, set a reminder for yourself if you think you're spending too much time on these apps. I think that mediums like Instagram, Pinterest, Facebook, and YouTube can be great ways to learn new things. For example, watching a video like this one is an excellent use of your time. But make sure that you're not only consuming the information, learn, get inspired, then start applying what you've learned to your own life. Before I get into tip number 4, I'm curious to know, what do you waste more time on, TV or social media? Comment down below and let me know, or simply click on the poll that I've inserted, I think right here, and vote. All right, let's make the most of our time and get into tip number 4, audiobooks. I started listening to audiobooks fairly recently, and not only have I become addicted to them, but so has my husband. We love listening to books and we're constantly learning so much. I buy my books from Audible, and I also place holds on everything I want to listen to at the library. Audiobooks are great because you can listen to them while you're doing mundane tasks like driving, cooking, cleaning. And I know that a lot of people think they'll have a hard time focusing if they don't actually read the words, and this is true. I experienced this years ago when I first tried an audiobook, and I gave up on audiobooks when this happened. But I've since realized what the issue was that I had picked a book I wasn't interested in. If there's something you really want to learn, then try to find books on that topic, and I guarantee you, you will focus. Lately, I've been wanting to learn more about marketing, social media, parenting. So I picked some bestsellers on those topics, and it's completely changed my life. And the best part is I can listen to them while doing other things, so it's a great use of time. And I know a lot of people listen to podcasts, which I've also done, but to be honest, they don't compare to audiobooks. Podcasts are free, so there's only so much information you're going to get from them. Most podcasters are also constantly promoting products, which I don't blame them for doing. How else are they gonna make money? But as a listener, it can get a bit annoying. I find that audiobooks are a totally different experience and provide so much value. In the description box down below, I've listed a link to Audible. By simply clicking on that link, you'll get 2 free books if you're in the US and 1 free book if you're in Canada if you decide to sign up for Audible. Give it a try, you have nothing to lose. All right, I have a million other productivity tips, but I value your time, so I'm only gonna give you one last tip. Tip number 5, simplify. By decluttering and simplifying your life, you will automatically save a ton of time. If you haven't seen my capsule wardrobe video yet, check it out. By having a capsule wardrobe, I save myself so much time every single day. I explain why and how in that video. Decluttering your home will give you less stuff to manage, less stuff to clean and put away. It's a great way to save time. You should also consider simplifying your life when it comes to activities and social events. If you're always out and about socializing, you can really waste a lot of time. You don't always have to be on the go. Take some time to be at home and focus on getting your own stuff done. Work on that unfinished home project you've been meaning to get to, but just couldn't find the time. You have time. You're probably just wasting a lot of it. I know it's more fun to be out all the time socializing, but it's so much more rewarding and gratifying to take care of yourself, your family, and your home. Earlier I talked about all the lists that I make. Well, if you're interested in learning how I organize all of the things I need to get done, how do I keep track of everything, how do I schedule it, how do I meal plan, how do I keep track of every family member's schedule, what's my cleaning schedule like, how do I organize every room in my home, and so on, then pay attention. I'm working on an online program called Clear the Clutter that will help you get organized step by step. If you're interested in learning how to organize your entire home, implement organization systems that actually work, learn how to meal plan, create a detailed home maintenance and cleaning schedule, then sign up on the waitlist for my Clear the Clutter program. The link is in the description box down below. Once the program launches, you will be notified and provided with more information. Next week, I'm going to be sharing some pretty good packing tips that can be used when traveling with or without children. You're not going to want to miss that video, so be sure to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so that you'll be notified when that video is posted. Don't forget to hit that like button and share this video with someone that you know would find it useful. And if you like this video, be sure to check out one of these ones. They're full of tips and tricks that will help you get more organized. As always, thanks for watching, guys, and happy tidying. Bye!